Hey there, I'm Brian, and I've been building stuff in Angular for a really long time. And now I'm sharing my knowledge and experience with developers like you, dedicated to mastering their craft and building amazing apps. Today, we're diving into host and host context, two powerful selectors for styling Angular components. These selectors originate from web components, where encapsulated styling is essential. Angular's Vue encapsulation mechanism uses the shadow DOM, or at least emulates it, to scope component styles. Host lets us style the component's root element, and host context lets us apply styles based on the context of something higher up in the DOM tree. Let's look at how and why we may want to use them. Here, we have a simple application showing a basic signup form. We need to add a visual container around the contents of this form. So let's open up the style sheet for this component. Now, in order to apply styles to the root element of this component, we'll use the host pseudo class. This is how we access the root element for our styles. Now, let's add a border to this element. Okay, let's save and see how it looks. Well, that doesn't look like a border now, does it? Well, this is because since this Angular component uses a custom element, the browser knows nothing about it. This means there's no style information, so it is essentially rendered inline. So let's add display block to the styles and try again. Nice. Now that's looking more like we'd expect, right? Okay, now let's round the corners a little. And let's give it a background color too. Okay, let's see how it looks now. Well, that's definitely looking better now, right? So we can use this host pseudo class to style the root element of our component, but this also means that these styles will always apply when this component is used. This may not be exactly what we want. Like here in our blog, where the form opens within a modal, we don't want the border or the background color here. So how can we handle this? Well, we can actually use a class in conjunction with the host pseudo class. To do this, let's first add a class to the signup form element in the homepage component. Let's call it contained. Okay, now back in our style sheet, we just need to add this class selector within parentheses. So now these styles will only apply when this class has been added to the host element. Let's save and check it out. Okay, let's open the modal. Nice, there's no container here now since this instance doesn't have our new contained class. Now let's go back over to the signup page. Nice, we still have a container here because we've added the class in this case. So this concept definitely comes in handy in certain situations. But what if we decide that we want every instance of this form to get the container styles except when placed within a modal? Do we always have to add this container class? Nope, we have a better way. We can use the host context pseudo class instead. Let's start by removing the container class concept. Okay, now these styles will apply to all instances of this component. Now let's remove the styles that we don't want in modals. We need to use the host context pseudo class for this. Now, we need to provide a selector to use for context. In this case, we'll use the app modal element selector. So anytime the form root component is nested within the app modal element, this selector will match. Now, let's remove the background color. And let's also remove the border. Okay, that should do it. Let's save and take a look. Okay, this form looks good with the container. Let's switch over and check the modal. Nice, no container here now. So now, anytime the component is added outside of a modal, it will get the container styles. But anytime it is added within the modal, these container styles will automatically be removed. So now we've seen how host helps us style a component's root element, and how host context allows us to apply styles based on where a component is used. Understanding and using these techniques will make your Angular components more flexible, maintainable, and visually consistent across your app. If you found this helpful, you may also want to check out my course all about styles in Angular. Also, check out my channel for more Angular tips and tricks. Until next time, thanks for watching.